23ABC's digital update is brought to you by West Medical.
I'm Mike Hart. Here's a look at what we're following on this Wednesday. As Kern County reverts back to the most restrictive tier, officials are reporting 5 new deaths this morning attributed to the coronavirus. Public health officials say the total number has now reached 437. Officials say that number of the cases since the pandemic began has now topped 37,200. Of those, more than 27,000 have recovered or are believed to have recovered, with another 9,800 isolating at home. The COVID dashboard at the Kern County's website no longer contains the number of people who are hospitalized. More than 84% of all COVID tests in Kern County have come back negative. And a change to California's mask protocol due to a surge in cases, you are now required to wear a face covering when you leave your home. The new guidelines now specifically state that the mask must cover your mouth and nose. The new guidelines apply to everyone unless they meet a specific exemption. And as far as testing sites, tomorrow, Adventist Health Delano, Kaiser Permanente, and the Kern County Latino Task Force are offering a free drive-through flu shot and COVID-19 testing event at Robert F. Kennedy High School in Delano. It'll take place from 2:30 to 5. No pre-registration is required. The task force is then holding an event Friday from 12 to 3 at Taft Union High School, where Dignity Health will also provide a limited number of flu shots. Then Saturday at 11 a.m., there will be a testing at the McFarland Community Center on Sherwood Avenue. Right now, let's bring in Elena and get a check of that Wednesday forecast.
Hey, good morning. Yesterday was an incredible 87 degrees, warm and dry out there, setting a new record for the day. Now we are back to those mid-60s, so quite the snap, and it's all because of that cold front pushing through the region. With organized rain and snow in Northern California this morning, just some light scattered showers here at home. By 7 a.m. this morning, you were seeing that cold front was passing through and will continue to have the scattered showers until about lunchtime. Mainly the best chance to see those showers will be in the clouds that get stuck against the foothills and up into the mountains, but it's not cold enough for snow, even though it is much colder than yesterday, and some fresh breezes will continue to clear us out this afternoon before some more clouds fill in the overnight hours. So with that, our future rain and snow totals less than a tenth countywide. Really, some of you are staying completely dry. Some of you will try to pick up a few hundredths if you're lucky.
And that's a look at the stories we're covering right now. Don't forget, you can find breaking news, weather, and traffic anytime, anywhere, simply by downloading our free mobile and tablet apps. We'll have another update for you right here later today.